Hello and welcome to episode 34 of the 1001 Movies podcast, based on the book 1001 Movies You Must See Before You Die. This time we'll be discussing Danny Boyle's 2008 drama, Slumdog Millionaire.
And what type of call center would that be?
XL5 mobile phones.
Oh, so you're the one who calls me up every single day of my life with special offers, huh?
Actually, I'm an assistant.
An assistant phone basher? And what does the assistant phone basher do exactly?
I get tea for people and...
Chaiwala. A chaiwala! Well, ladies and gentlemen, Jamal Malik, garba garam chai dene wala from Mumbai. Let's play Who Wants to Be a Millionaire?
Danny Boyle's career began like many other directors we've talked about in this podcast. He began working in theater in college, later started directing for television, and eventually hit it big with a single independently produced film that put his name on the map. Although the 1994 thriller Shallow Grave is pretty much lauded as one of the best films of the genre during the 90s, it wasn't until 1996 when he made a mark with Trainspotting. This film is a topic for another podcast episode, as it has its own entry in the book, but it's the moment when British-born Boyle burned his signature mark into 90s independent film. His post-MTV style hit a nerve with audiences who enjoyed a bit of frenetic fantasy with the reality, and Boyle followed it up 4 years later with a Leonardo DiCaprio vehicle, The Beach. At this point, the offers began pouring in at a steady stream, and Boyle dipped his toe in the horror genre with 2002's 28 Days Later, and science fiction with 2007's Sunshine, still using the signature style that he made popular with Trainspotting. Danny Boyle's career, of course, was far from over. Producers at Film 4 had acquired the rights to Vikas Swarup's book Q&A, about a young Indian man who finds love and fortune as a contestant on his country's version of Who Wants to Be a Millionaire. Screenwriter Simon Beaufoy, who had written The Full Monty in 1997, wrote the script and renamed it Slumdog Millionaire. Beaufoy would later take credit for creating the word slumdog, which pertained to a child from the slums of Mumbai. Danny Boyle was brought to the director's helm after a little trepidation about filming a movie about a game show, and soon locations in Mumbai were scouted and actors were hired, beginning with British actor Dev Patel as the older version of the film's protagonist. Patel had previously been known for the British television drama Skins. For the two of you that have not seen this film yet, it centers on Jamal Malik, a young boy from Mumbai, who finds himself a contestant on Who Wants to Be a Millionaire. As he answers each of the questions, most of his story is told in flashbacks, explaining the eventful moments in his life that led to him knowing the correct answers. The journey is framed with Jamal's troublesome relationship with his brother Salim and his love of a beautiful girl named Latika, both of which take center stage in Jamal's growth from boyhood to a young man. It ends melodramatically with Jamal correctly answering the final question in the game show and simultaneously reuniting with Latika. Casting had started with Dev Patel, but the filmmakers scoured Mumbai to cast non-actors to play the three leads as young children and teenagers. Bollywood star and Indian household name Anil Kapoor was cast as the game show host, and other cast members included Irfan Khan, who would later be known as the adult protagonist in Ang Lee's Life of Pi. Although Danny Boyle has often been given credit for the direction of the film, he didn't really completely do it alone. Loveleen Tandon, who began as one of the film's casting directors, was later given the credit of co-director by Boyle himself, who recognized her contributions in working with the non-English-speaking actors. Opening on Christmas Day in 2008, it was clear that the distributors set Slumdog Millionaire up as Oscar bait, and they weren't disappointed. A financial and critical success, it went on to win Academy Awards for Best Picture, Best Director, Best Adapted Screenplay, Best Cinematography, Best Film Editing, Best Sound Mixing, Best Score, and Best Song for Jai Ho, the Bollywood-style dance number at the film's conclusion. But even after the Oscars, Slumdog Millionaire was not without scandal. The six young actors and actresses who played the lead roles as youngsters were allowed to attend the ceremony in tuxedos and ball gowns, but they were immediately flown back to Mumbai to return to their poverty-stricken lives. Danny Boyle provided a trust for the two youngest ones, payable contingent on them finishing school, and they were moved from the slums and into apartments in better districts. It's unclear whether this act of charity was the result of scandal or if it was in the filmmakers' plans from the beginning. Boyle's career, of course, was a runaway train with no hint of stopping, and he helmed another Oscar-nominated project in 2010 with 127 hours, and just recently in 2015 with Steve Jobs. What did I think of Slumdog Millionaire? Back in episode 7, we talked about Diwar, the 1975 Bollywood film about two brothers, one who becomes a cop and the other a gangster. As I watched Slumdog Millionaire again, I was reminded of Diwar and how ridiculously melodramatic it was. Slumdog, as I mentioned, is just as melodramatic, with our hero being reunited with his love via his phone-a-friend lifeline on the game show, followed by a sequence in which he runs to meet up with her at a train station. It concludes with a song and dance sequence, the same type of scene I found so off-putting in Diwar. The charm of Slumdog Millionaire, however, is that all of this melodrama actually works, and it isn't until the movie is over and you're driving home that you realize how unlikely and unridiculous the whole thing is. Indeed, the film opens with a question in the titles, how did Jamal Malik come to be in the hot seat? A. He's a genius. B. He's lucky. C. He cheated. Or D. It is written. At first, it seems the obvious answer is that he's simply lucky, an Indian counterpart to Forrest Gump. But by the end, we believe in Jamal's faith, and that it is indeed written. The relationship among the three lead characters is troublesome at best. Jamal does what is best for his brother Salim and makes many attempts to help Latika on their struggle for survival on the streets. Every time Jamal becomes closer to Latika, his love is thwarted by Salim. But at the conclusion, it is Salim, going down in a blaze of bullets, who was responsible for saving Latika's life. The melodrama is supported by the backdrop in Mumbai, a place with a fine line between the upper and lower class, and where poverty, disease, and ethnic cleansing are bleak reminders of reality. Of course, Danny Boyle's direction is top-notch, using some of the edgy style he's known for in Trainspotting and 28 Days Later. Digital filters of varying colors, quick cuts, and just a dash of black-and-white cinematography along with some slow-motion shots. This is the type of direction that gave his viewers panic attacks in 28 Days Later, but instead Boyle creates a frenetic, fantastic fairy tale. It's well deserving of all the Oscars it won. That's all I have to say about Slumdog Millionaire. Tune in next week for a discussion on the 1935 action classic Captain Blood, directed by Michael Curtiz and starring Errol Flynn and Olivia de Havilland. Feel free to email questions and comments to me at 1001moviespodcast@gmail.com. Follow me on Twitter at 1001moviespc and like the Facebook page. Until next time, happy viewing.